Jay Leno's Newport Mansion has all the creature comforts inside, plus some interesting creatures outside.
Jay, we're in the garden, and there's even antiques out here.
Right, right.
Tell me about the weather vane.
Well, I was hoping you could tell me something about the weather vane. I've been up on the roof, but never examined it up close. I don't know if it's a one-off, if somebody made it specifically for this house, or I don't know anything about it.
I don't believe that it's a 19th century weather vanes, which is most of the ones that we see in America, the antique ones. I think this is a custom-made piece from the probably 2000 to not very long ago.
Right.
You can get these weather vanes done in the $15,000 range, and then they start going up. This is a mermaid form.
Right.
And she's got a shell that she's holding, which is a rarer form for the 19th century. We see them much more in the 20th and 21st.
Right.
It just seems to be one of those symbols that people love. This one is particularly beautifully made. If you look at the directionals, I mean, that's always a nice sign for the quality of a weather vane. But I would say probably in the $15,000 to $25,000 range to buy it new.
Right.
If you had to have it fabricated.
Did you notice the peacock out on the...
I saw that.
In 1947, the lady bought this house and redid it after being devastated in 38. And she had that in the garden, basically right out here, as a centerpiece. Then there was a huge hurricane. Water came and swept it out to sea. That was the end of that. Then 10 years later, she sold the house. Then 20 years later, she comes to visit the new owners sometime in the 90s, and she sees the peacock out on the lawn again. And she says to them, and it's hers. It's a bit battered and beat up. And
she says,
where did that come from? They said, oh, we had a huge storm one day, and the peacock just showed up on the lawn the next day. So apparently got swept out to sea, stayed out there for a couple of decades, and then was swept back in again.
Oh, my gosh.
At least it came back,
so that's
good. So maybe it's a homing peacock.
So the peacock is a symbol of many, many things. And one of the symbols is resurrection. Because they lose these tail feathers,
right,
and then they grow back again. So there's biblical references to the peacock. So that's kind of cool.
Yeah,
so this is sort of a resurrection. This thing left, and then it came back again.
Kind of like my career. I work for NBC, so that their symbol is a peacock, and so there you go.
Wow, wow. I mean, it's a great, complicated story. So any idea of its value?
I have no idea. I have no idea of its value. I mean, I think the story makes it valuable. Mm-hmm. So I think it's more in the provenance almost than in the actual value of the statue.
I think it's a pretty cool thing.
Yeah.
And I think there is a vibrant market in garden statuary.
Right.
Maybe an auction estimate of $10,000 to $15,000.
Okay, that's pretty
good. You know, and I think it would do better than that.
Yeah, all right.
It's a really... I love the tail,
right,
drapes down.
You just don't know what's going to run off again. You know, it's like Runaway Bride. It's one of those things that shows up and it disappears for decades and it comes back.